Good day to each and everyone. I am Reynaline N. Ramilo. Today, I will discuss about Solomon Islands. But before I start, let us listen to their national anthem, entitled God Save Our Solomon Islands. So now, let us start. Solomon Islands is a sovereign state consisting of 6 major islands and over 900 smaller islands in Oceania, to the east of Papua New Guinea and northwest of Vanuatu, and covering a land area of 28,400 square kilometers. The country has a population of 652,858. And its capital is Honiara. It is located on the islands of Guadalcanal. The country takes its name from the Solomon Islands archipelago, which is a collection of Melanesian islands that also includes the North Solomon Islands. It is a part of Papua New Guinea, but excludes outlying islands such as Reunel and Bellona, and the Santa Cruz Islands. The islands have been settled since at least 30,000 to 28,000 before Christ, with later waves of migrants, notably the Lapita people, mixing and producing the modern indigenous Solomon Islanders populations. In 1568, the Spanish navigator Alvaro de Mendaña was the first European to visit them, naming them the Islas Salomon. Mendaña returned decades later in 1595 and other Spanish expedition, led by Portuguese. Navigator Pedro Fernandez de Queiroz visited the Solomons in 1606. Britain defined its area of interest in the Solomon Islands archipelago in June 1893, when Captain Gibson, RN of HMS Curacao, declared the Southern Solomon Islands a British protectorate. During World War II, the Solomon Islands campaign 1942 to 1945 saw fierce fighting between the United States, Commonwealth forces, and the Empire of Japan, such as in the Battle of Guadalcanal. The official name of then British administration was changed from the British Solomon Islands Protectorate to the Solomon Islands in 1975, and self-government was achieved the following year. Independence was obtained, and the name changed to just Solomon Islands, without the definite article, in 1978. At independence, Solomon Islands became a constitutional monarchy. The Queen of Solomon Islands is Elizabeth II, represented by the Governor General. Politics of Solomon Islands takes place within the framework of a parliamentary representative democratic constitutional monarchy. Solomon Islands is an independent commonwealth realm where executive power is exercised by the government. Legislative power is vested in both the government and a multi-party parliament. The head of state, the king or queen of Solomon Islands, is represented by the Governor General. The head of the government is the Prime Minister. The constitutional safeguards include freedom of speech, press, worship, movement, and association. The judiciary is independent of the executive and the legislature. Let's move on to the economic system of the Solomon Islands. Solomon Islands' economic freedom score is 52.9, making its economy the 150th freest in the 2020 index. Its overall score has decreased by 1.7 points due to a drop in the fiscal health score. The Solomon Islands is ranked 36th among 42 countries in the Asia-Pacific region, and its overall score is well below the regional and world averages. The economy of the Solomon Islands climbed into the mostly unfree category in 2017 and has remained there ever since then. GDP growth over the past 5 years has been solid due to continued infrastructure development, expansion of tuna processing, and construction of the Tina River hydropower project. To expand economic freedom in the Solomon Islands, the government would have to address the most pressing problems first, beginning with government integrity. Tackling corruption was a key electoral promise of the current government, and Parliament passed an anti-corruption bill in 2019. The scene of some of World War II's bitterest fighting, the South Pacific archipelago of the Solomon Islands, gained independence from the United Kingdom in 1976 and became a parliamentary democracy. In 2003, after years of ongoing and economically destructive ethnic violence, an Australian-led multinational force disarmed ethnic militias, restored law, and ordered and rebuilt government institutions. In 2019, Manasseh Sogavare was re-elected Prime Minister, having previously served as Prime Minister from 2014 to 2017. Although the islands are rich in timber and such undeveloped mineral resources as lead, zinc, nickel, and gold, much of the population continues to work in subsistence farming, fishing, and artisanal forestry. The Solomon Islands remains one of Asia's poorest nations. Now, let us proceed to their rule of law. Land ownership is reserved for Solomon Islanders, and conflicts over land tenure have been a major source of civil unrest. The judiciary's lack of resources hinders the conduct of timely trials and leads to weak enforcement of contracts. Residents of rural areas have limited access to the formal justice system. Corruption is a serious problem in the judicial, mining, and fishing sectors. What is their government size? The top personal income tax rate is 40%, and the top corporate tax rate is 30%. Other taxes include property and sales taxes. The overall tax burden equals 30.6% of total domestic income. Government spending has amounted to 46.8% of the country's output or GDP over the past 3 years, and the budget deficits have averaged 3.8% of GDP. Public debt is equal to 12.1% of GDP. Their regulatory efficiency. Action to advance business freedom has been marginal. The new government is trying to formulate its priorities regarding business-friendly reforms. The formal labor market has not fully developed, and most of the population relies on agriculture, fishing, and forestry for all or part of its livelihood. Subsidies for infrastructure development projects, funded mainly by international donors, comprise about 1/3 of total public spending. After I end this video, let us watch the cultural dance of Solomon Islands. Enjoy watching!